About 1 year ago, I made this video about reverse engineering. Find cylinders, spheres and planars on a given CAD model. And today I want to show two methods to approximate on objects such figures. Let's assume we have such surfaces, and with some fantasy we can see here structures like a cylinder inside. And now the question is how to find the best cylinder to describe this object. Or also we can discuss how to find a cube, which is a good approximation, a sphere, which is a good approximation of these objects. This is the cylinder inside, and also we have it here. Okay, and what I do is I have now two more nodes in Pyflow. The one is find cylinder and the other is find sphere. And the algorithm in this node is to use some points of the surface and find the best fitting sphere or the best fitting cylinder for this surface. So here in this scenario I have a reference of the basic object. It's a B-tube of my NURBS workbench, and from here the face is used by these two nodes, and the sphere or the cylinder is calculated. And with this connection, it means that always when I update the B-tube, then the two solutions are recomputed. Let's see it here. Okay, I start here with this B-tube, and now I can change here some parameter. I can change the noise, say, to 2000, and we see the figure changes and also the approximation changes. And we also can display here the sphere. This is the sphere. That means this sphere has a middle point and a radius in that way that the poles of this green surface have the same mean distance to the center of the sphere, and the same we can do here for the other example. So we have an approximation of this tube by a cylinder, this one, and I hide it, and we have the approximation by this sphere. And I also can now go here and can change, for example, in this case, I can change the value from, oh, I have some problems with my mouse. I can change this value to say 9000. In this case, there is very strong noise on the figure, but still, I see here a useful approximation by this cylinder. Using the cylinder, it is possible to map the points of the surface to a cylinder surface, to unfold the cylinder surface, and to do algorithms on the unfolded cylinder, and then re-transform all the data back to the 3D phase. So this is all. The nodes will have two inputs, a shape where I use a UV grid to calculate the approximation, or also it is possible to use a points array. That means a point cloud with some structure.